get ready to match the stars from ABC Weekend Special, Willie Tyler and Lester. Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lynn Redgrave, McLean Stevenson, and Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
It's that Russian seltzer water that she drinks. Softens her
you
brain.
You run upstairs. Change your clothes. The person my age, you try to,
too much,
you know,
too much
perform a couple
the
of ablutions.
The MC is in for a surprise. Oh, there it goes. It was stuck.
Oh, it got stuck.
Gone too far.
Here
remember
we go.
The day the two went all the way to El Segundo on that? You didn't know? Just went right down the freeway.
That's the first good laugh he's given me this week.
All right. Here we have Kathy Stevens and Vicki Evans. Kathy is you're the college student, right, Vicki?
Yes, a recent graduate, and I'm taking some classes now so I can get my teacher credential.
You want to be a teacher?
Yes.
And Kathy, refresh our memories about you, please.
I'm the exercise to go.
Oh, that's right. Oh, you're the exercise to go lady. And you're married?
Yes.
But you go to people's homes and you keep them in good shape.
Well, we will, but normally it's more like corporate agencies or large business employment agencies.
Naturally. Right. All right. Whose turn is it? Your turn, Vicki, because you're ahead 2-0 here. That means you have to go first, round 2.
B.
B. All right. B. See how good she is? Went to college.
B.
Just distinguish between A and B. Dumb Donald is so dumb. After the doctor told him to eat lots of greens, Donald went out and ate a blank. All right, Vicki. Dumb Donald is so dumb. After the doctor told him to eat lots of greens, Donald went out and ate a blank.
A bush.
A bush.
A bush.
All right. Which one of you guys going to speak here?
Let's see. Greens. You know, that's something. We live in the same neighborhood, but not exactly, right? Not exactly. You know, out here it's like basically golf course, if you will.
A golf course. A wonderful answer. Now, that's not a day of wishy-washy applause. If it comes up with a good answer, I want to hear it for him. That's the way to go. What do you say?
But this is in that genre. I mean, it's not a golf course, but now that they've got the pooper scooper in New York, you could eat a lawn.
Eat a lawn. All right.
It's like a sing-along. How about Mr.?
Oh, I didn't play.
He matched in the previous round. Do you have a good answer?
Well, the same as the dummy golf course.
Which one?
After the doctor told me lots of greens, Donald went out and ate a...
Yeah, mine's a very dumb answer. I apologize. A jolly green giant.
No, I think that's a wonderful answer. I love that answer. I'm going to love your answer.
I bet you will. I bet you will love this answer. Even though it may sound very familiar to you, I bet you'll love it anyway.
Sure.
Golf course.
Wonderful answer.
Come on, now you cheered the rest of
That's a very good answer.
Well, that's better. Thank you.
Now, Kathy, you need 2 to tie, 3 to win. Beverly Hills is really ritzy.
Sure is.
Last week there was a demonstration, and instead of water, the police hosed down the crowd with blank. Brett's about ready. Beverly Hills is really ritzy. Last week there was a demonstration, and instead of water, the police hosed down the crowd with blank.
Well, same thing we drink after my exercise classes, champagne.
Champagne. All right. What do you say to that?
Well, basically, like in Detroit, we would drink what? Beer and stuff like that. You know, the thing like, no, we didn't say that, but you know, being like Beverly Hills, that's ritzy, right? So
right.
Put the silver plate. Champagne, if you will.
Champagne. Very good. All right. 1 for Kathy, 2-1 the score. What do you say?
Am I the villainess?
No. I've got a long way to go for that.
Heaven forfend.
You are anyway.
I say a vintage 1967 champagne of Cordon Rouge.
Tie score. What do you say, Buster?
Liquor after the exercise class?
And before.
Just for the teacher.
Hey, well, we were right then in my school. We had gym. We used to have vodka stingers before and Harvey Wallbangers after.
Aha! All right, that wins the game. Come on down, Kathy. What does the bottom tier have? Champagne? Everybody has champagne. Now, Vicky, you were going to roll you off here, but we'll roll you back on again later, so don't get too far away, all right? See you later.
Come
game
on
number
back,
two.
Vicky.
Now we'll see how we go here with game number one for the big super match. We polled an audience not too long ago, and we said, what do you think is the best answer to this? A little more there. Thank you very much. There. Lauren Blank.
Oh, let me think. Now, just a minute. I didn't think of...
She hasn't called on you yet.
No, I'm just thinking.
She, you call on whoever you want. Don't be intimidated by Brett.
Don't call on her because...
Brett. Now, just a minute. Lauren Bacall?
All right. Lynn has one.
Lynn.
Lauren Hutton.
Lauren Hutton. Marcia?
Lauren Hardy.
Lauren Green.
All right. He spells his a little differently.
No kidding, Gene.
Yeah.
No kidding.
But that dumb bunch might have said that. Let's take a look at the $100 response.
You have to ask me first.
Oh, what? That's right.
Oh, that's right, I do. Okay.
Okay, my three choices,
right.
Lauren Bacall, Lauren Hutton, Lauren Green.
I choose Lauren Bacall.
I'll go for your choice.
All right. All right, go ahead.
The $100 column here.
Ah, see? See?
That's and the $250.
Yeah. Lauren Hutton.
And here the $500.
Big time. Yeah.
Whoa. All right.
You'll do anything for a glass of champagne.
That's right. We're going to do a little business with America and come back and see how much money she wins. Hubler. Hello, here we are. Now, the lady's won the $500. It means at least she'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But let's see how she does with the wheel. Maybe she'll play for $10,000. Who knows? Well, good luck to you, my dear. McLean, you ready there?
Yo.
Here it is. No help from the audience, please. Pigs Blank. Take a look at it, and I'll show it to McLean. Pigs Blank. Now, your job is to match McLean. If you do that, you get a bundle of money here. What do you say?
Well, not to reflect on my housekeeping, but pigsty.
Pigsty.
Pigs what?
No,
pigs what?
She misunderstood, but we have to take it as her answer. It's all right. Well, pigsty is P-I-G-S-T-Y. It could be pigsty. We had pigs, P-I-G apostrophe S, and that's why I wanted her to see it and wanted McLean to see it too, so we all understood. What do you say?
What would you have said had you realized that it was pigs?
Probably pigs in a blanket.
Pigs in a blanket.
Well, then I don't feel too bad because I said pig's feet.
It's all right. You'll make up the money. We'll all come to your class. Now, let's get your opponent back here and play game number two. Welcome back, Vicky. Are you ready to have a go at it here? All right, we'll go for it. Game number two, round number one. You want A or B?
A.
All right. Ugly Elfria is really ugly.
Oh, bro.
Well, she hates dogs because her legs look like blanks. I'd like to see him drink a glass of water, write the answer, and have Lester
smoke a cigarette
and Lester recite a poem at the same time. Ugly Elfrida is really ugly. She hates dogs because her legs look like blanks.
All I can think of is sticks.
Sticks.
Did I say something wrong?
Does dogs chase sticks? Is that why? Wrong!
There's your boyfriend out there rooting for you, right? Down to the nitty-gritty.
Right to the end.
All right. Who's going to answer?
I hope I got this right, Gene. Let's see. This young woman hates dogs because...
Her legs look like...
Yeah. Looks like... Dog's legs looks like hers.
Like hers?
Her legs.
Because her legs look like...
Yeah, you can't win them all. You know, some days she doesn't take the suitcase, you know what I mean?
Right. This was one of those days.
Hello.
Yeah.
I think this is going to be a popular favorite, although it does not actually match. Hydrants.
Hydrants. An excellent response, Charles.
Is there any chance you'll be going down south soon again?
All right, we have two of those. Fire hydrants. She hates dogs because her legs look like what?
Hydrants.
Hydrants. That's the response. So, McLean?
I, too, said fire hydrants.
All right. That's, yes.
I would like to go on record as pointing out that that's the second ugly Althea question this week with no ugly Albert questions.
Well, no.
I'm sure you'll balance those off next week.
Wait. We do not have an Althea on this program in our question. It's Ulfria. A mythical name we made up so as not to offend anyone.
Well, she is female, however. There is that. You see?
All right.
You tell him, man.
Good night.
Did you see me wearing my ERA button?
Yes, I see that, and I know where you stand on these issues. I just think perhaps a mythical name of a male nature might be good.
All right, I'll do it for you. Ugly Albert is really ugly. He hates dogs. Shut up. He hates dogs because his legs look like blanks.
Tree trunks?
Wrong.
Tree trunks. Okay, now, let's see what we have for you. Ready?
Well, I have a wrong answer.
Nancy said, I'm on a new diet. All I can eat is honey. This morning I had an uncontrollable urge to blank.
I'm on a new
diet. Here we go. Nancy said, I'm on a new diet. All I can eat is honey. This morning I had an uncontrollable urge to blank.
Gosh, it's hard. I'll say pollinate.
To pollinate?
Was it?
Pollinate.
Was it, Jim?
Pollinate.
What a wonderful answer. Oh, boy. Talk about too smart for the room.
Wow. Geez.
Very good, huh?
We thought about that later on down the line, but no, we didn't say that. We said fly or buzz.
Fly or buzz, as bees do.
Thank you.
What do you say?
I'm very disappointed in myself. I'm crushed. And why didn't I think of that? I said sting my best friend.
Sting my best friend.
Yeah.
This morning I had an uncontrollable urge.
To sting the mailman, milkman, and the greengrocer.
Uh-huh.
Pollinate's fabulous.
All at one time. This morning I had an uncontrollable urge to...
To buzz.
To buzz.
To buzz.
These do that.
Yes.
Yes, is that in your way there?
Yes.
Let's put that over here.
Yes.
All right. What do you say, McLean?
My answer was designed so that it wouldn't offend the crank. I said, sting somebody, person, woman, and or man.
It's a dirty spot, but somebody's got to fill it. Now,
somebody's
right?
Got to be there.
That's right.
And you fill it more than adequately.
Thank you so much. I woke up with an uncontrollable urge to buzz off.
Good. So here we go to round two, and it's a tie, 0-0. And since she went first last time, you go first this time.
Okay, I'll go for A.
All right.
Pollinate.
Frank said, my car is so small, I don't need a garage. When I get home, I just put it in the blank. Frank said, my car is so small, I don't need a garage. When I get home, I just put it in a blank.
I'll say doghouse.
Doghouse is Kathy Stevens' answer.
Oh, another one.
What do you say to that, Willie?
Well, that's, kind of, but not really. I'd say just basically house, if you will.
Put it in the house instead of in the garage. It could squeeze right through the front door.
There it is.
I said laundry room.
Laundry room. Doghouse is what we're looking for, Chuck.
I suppose that governor starts it in the morning. Mailbox.
In the mailbox. Car so small, when I get home, I just put it in the blank.
Yeah, something much smaller. The briefcase, I think.
In the briefcase,
that's
a small car.
Yeah,
very
small
good.
Car, yeah.
How small was that car, McLean?
If we light up one light, do we go to the wheel?
No, oh, not yet.
We got another question for Vicky.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm out of line. But in any event, I said doghouse.
Uh-huh. Under Kathy.
I'd like to commend her on her two fabulous answers and wish that I matched them, but I didn't. Den.
In the den. All right. So Kathy has one, and that means, Vicky, all you need is one to tie and two to win. At the restaurant, Roger said to the waiter, "Hey, I don't mind flies swimming in my soup, but these flies are standing on the edge of my bowl and blinking." All right.
No.
At the restaurant, Roger said to the waiter, "Hey, I don't mind flies swimming in my soup, but these flies are standing on the edge of my bowl and blanking."
Waving. The waving at you.
Waving. Wait. I think you just blew it.
Oh, what do they know?
Yeah. Right.
That's right, Vicky.
You tell them.
Well, okay. The definitive answer that I came up with, or me and my partner here, Les, came up with, was basically tinkling, if you will.
Tinkling. Yeah, that's... All right.
I think he was standing on the edge of the pool and diving.
Tinkling and diving? Very good. Both of them, very good.
I was going to say drinking poolside sangria, but that's hard, so diving.
Diving is good. All right. Flies are standing on the edge of my bowl and whatting.
Oh, they're spitting.
Aha! Yes. McLean?
I just whip it out and diving.
Diving. All right.
They don't whip it out in diving.
Aha. Uh-huh. Okay. So that means Kathy wins the game with one. Now, Vicky, it was a pleasure to meet you. Good luck in your teaching career.
Thank
Vicky
you.
Evans, ladies and gentlemen. There she goes. Thank you some prizes, my dear. Bye. Here's a little message for you. Hurry back.
Again, the star of our show, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we go with Captain Stevens, who won game number two. We're going to have another go at the big money. We polled an audience, and what do you think is a good answer to this? Money can't buy blank. Who do you want to call
so
on for
true.
A little help here?
So true.
So true. Well, I'll go with Willie and Lester. Get
money
two minds.
Money can't buy happiness. Yeah.
All right.
Okay, and then I'll go with Charles.
Oh, don't say it. It's gonna be too sad.
I thought that Lester might say money can't buy a bloodstream. No, money can't. Money can't buy. Say it,
oh, it's
Arlen.
So
wait,
sad.
Say it now.
Love. All
right. Money can't buy love. One more.
And McLean.
Help.
Money can't buy poverty.
Money can't buy poverty. Money can't buy love, and money can't buy happiness. You want one of those or one of your own?
I'm gonna go with money can't buy love.
All right. Let's see if we've got that under the $100 response. Money can't buy everything. Okay, the next one says money can't buy happiness. And now she says money can't buy love is on top. Is it? Yes, it is.
Very good.
Now, you know, that means you're going to play for $5,000 minimum. But you're going to spin the wheel again and see if you can double it up to 10. Good luck to you. Let's see how we do here. $5,000 with Charles Nelson Reilly. Good luck to you. And this is it. Blank ends. E-N-D-S.
E-N-D-S.
That's what I say.
But we say it one more time.
All right, your job is to match Charles. If you do that, you get $5,000. What do you say?
Well, I'm going to hope for split ends.
Now, every lady in the room, I'm sure, thinks split ends is a good answer, and it may be. But a guy really wouldn't think about split ends. You gals are preoccupied.
Oh, yeah. No, I thought of loose ends, and we've had split ends, but that's the girl's answer. The most common one I've... Bookend.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I didn't think of split ends until you said it. Listen, you haven't done too badly. You got $1,000, and we're very happy about that. Thank you, Kathy.
Good.
Thank you,
Radio.
Bye, my dear. Here's a little message for America. Charles has something he wants to say, Charles.
You know, my friends from Chino are here, who are the senior citizens of Chino, led by my friend Mitzi Gazik, whose husband, Mike Gazik, became a police officer at the age of 70 for his program to help security for the senior citizen at 70.
Let's hear it.
Mike.
Thank
Thank you all. Join us next time at the Match Game. Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive...
Brass Black Hawk Extra Lean Hams and Low Smoked over Genuine Hickory. Three distinct flavors, hickory smoked, honey glazed, barbecue glazed. From across the Pacific comes Hawaiian Tropic Natural Tanning Lotions and Oils, plus this Hawaiian Tropic Clothes, Hawaiian Tropic, the tan of the islands. Minwax finishes the beautified wood indoors for years, now Minwax goes outdoors. Get your home ready for weather and wearable exterior wood finished by Minwax. When you've got anything that sticks or squeaks, reach for WD-40. Makes things work smoother, last longer. Do it yourself with WD-40.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Topman production. This program was edited for broadcast.